We are closer than ever before to the release of Silksong, and I can't wait to play. But why is Hornet getting naked? To find out, I'll make my own Silksong in C++ from scratch. And while making the game, we might just find out why is Hornet taking off her clothes. And what's even better, instead of spending 6 years, I'm going to make it in one single day. Now, Team Cherry chose an inferior language called C# and Unity, but I'm going to also fix that today, by making it in C++ and using no engine. We'll also discuss whether it's better to create a game from scratch or use an engine. But let's see first if I'm up to the challenge, because I asked ChatGPT and one day is a lot less than 6 years, so wish me luck. And just as I started coding, I faced my first problem. There is very little Silksong content online, so I can't find many assets. But there is no time to waste, so I decided to recreate one zone from Silksong. After watching the trailer, I chose the Moss Grotto. It's very nice, but more importantly, I happen to have some sprites that might help us. You see, some time ago, I made a small Hollow Knight clone, and the sprites I made for this project look very similar to the Moss Grotto. So I just have to make them greener, and that's it. Now, if you think that I'm going to copy all of this Hollow Knight project, change the sprites around, and call it Silksong, you'd be absolutely right.
What?
But there are some changes and improvements that I need to make. Starting with adding a 3D camera. And you might be wondering, why do I need a 3D camera for a 2D game? Take a look at Silksong. Notice how the background objects move slower than the foreground ones. This effect is called parallax. It gives this nice 3D feel to 2D games. And it's easy to implement, but to keep things much simpler, Team Cherry actually just made the game in a 3D environment. And I need to do the same. And here is where people will tell you that using a game engine will make your life easier. But it really depends. If you know graphics programming, making something like this from scratch is actually surprisingly easy. I just started with my 2D rendering library and added a matrix multiplication. This will make everything 3D, and that's about it. And look, I even added some custom shaders to blur the background objects. But I'll return to the engine versus no engine debate later. Right now, we have a bigger problem to solve. I can't for the life of me find Silksong sprites to decorate the environment. I do have a graphics tablet. I could use it to draw my own sprites. But this would take too much time. Remember, I only have one day to make this project. But then I thought, what if I use ChatGPT to generate me the sprites? I tried this some time ago, and the results were horrible. The sprites made no sense, and they were not even separated into individual pieces. But let's give it a try anyway. So I asked to generate me some sprites for Silksong Moss Grotto, and the result was extremely good. The sprites looked very nice, and they were even separated into different pieces that I could easily extract. And because AI was so helpful so far, I kept going. I took a screenshot of the game, removed Hornet and other distractions, and expanded the image to get this background. It does look a little bit weird, but remember, this is why we have a blur shader, to hide any weird details in the background objects. And with all of that in place, we have a good start. But before I start making the level itself, the knight has to go, and I need to place Hornet instead. The full Hornet sprite was released, but I'm not putting that manually back together. Luckily, some people on Reddit already went through the pain of making the movement animation, also known as our movement animation. With that, we finally have Hornet, and we can start working on the level. I tried adding a lot of objects, both in front and in the back of the character, to make the area as full of vegetation as possible. And looking at the original game, Team Cherry made the front objects black. It's actually quite a good idea, because it makes the screen less crowded. So I did the same. And at first, my game looked very bad. But I just kept going, until eventually, damn, it starts looking kinda cool. I won't reveal the entire map yet, because remember, we still need to discover why is Hornet taking off her cloak, and I don't want to spoil it. Before that, I have one more thing I want to talk about. You can probably see these collision boxes here. Well, I was using a physics library called Box2D, and I was too lazy to change it. But normally, for a simple game like this, I would just code the collisions from scratch. Hollow Knight has very simple collisions and physics actually. My point is, rendering for this game is easy to implement. The physics is also easy to implement. And in fact, if you want smooth movement, you need to work on it a lot, no matter if you use an engine or not. And at this point, I'll just make the game in C++, and avoid the downsides of using an engine. Don't get me wrong, I have nothing against using game engines, but you have to understand that there are always pros and cons. Celeste, for example, was made in C#, and because of that, the garbage collector sometimes freezes the game. This fortunately doesn't happen in Hollow Knight, so good job Team Cherry. But that means that they were extra careful not to allocate random memory. In C++, however, you don't have this problem at all. And no, you don't have memory leaks problems either. There are some very easy things that you can do for game dev that I show in this video. Point is, both options have their strengths and weaknesses. Getting back to my implementation, the day is almost over. Hornet is still not naked, and I still need to place collision boxes. But with no time left, I manually hardcoded all of them in the code, Please don't roast me in the comments for this. But with that, I present you Silksong made in one day. Okay, I know it looks nothing like the real game, but for one day of work, I really like how these parallax effects turned out. Now, the moment you all have been waiting for. Why is Hornet removing her cloak? So she is climbing this thing, checking this nice parallax. I didn't have time to add enemies, nor have I found any sprites online, so I'll just add them in post. Shaw! Now what's that? It's the Shaw from the trailer, and she's getting naked. Wait, are you seeing what I'm seeing? Is that a Gucci logo? Damn! Hornet got a drip, let's go! I'm teaching game dev in C++ on this channel, so if you also want to learn this, check out this video and subscribe. See you!